Navdušen sem nad željo po izobraževanju, predvsem z področja dnevne svetlobe, in vidim, da ima to področje v Sloveniji veliko prihodnost, ker je tudi diskusija bila zelo zanimiva.
Zadnja stvar, ki je morda tudi okrogla miza pokazala, je pa ta, da je dejansko ukvarjanje z dnevno svetlobo na pravi način enako kompleksno kot svetloba sama. In tukaj seveda je pa na vseh nas, da naredimo tisto, kar se da, da bo trajnostno bivanje, bivalno ugodje in vse, kar želimo v življenju, pravzaprav res na taki ravni, kot pravzaprav pritiče tudi svetlobi, ki je ena od najplemenitejših stvari v naravi.
As architectural designers and engineers and medical practitioners, we need to understand that the built environment plays a critically important role in delivering health and well-being so that we can be our full humanity, so that we can live our lives relatively disease-free with life and vitality and getting enough sleep at night that we desperately need. And the amazing part, truly amazing part in all of this is that it's simple. All we have to do is bring the outside in and expose ourselves to the natural cycle of day and light. And here's some tips. In order to be able to accomplish that in our 24/7 environment, it's very, very simple. Get out in the morning, as soon as you wake up, get outside, at least before 9:30 in the morning. Get out and experience as much light as you can. If you wear contacts, take them out. If you wear glasses, take them off. Don't wear sunglasses and don't wear a hat. Expose your eyes and your skin to the sunlight. Make sure you eat within 8 to 10 hours of the first meal or the first sip of water you take in the morning. And at night, be sure to turn off all ceiling light levels after 8 o'clock in the evening hours. This is directly related to circadian system and our ability to take advantage of the natural cycle of day and light and night.
Zelo sem vesela, da lahko pri načrtovanju svetlobe v prostorih vedno več res dobrih, kvalitetnih podatkov uporabljamo. Lahko se zanesemo na vedno boljše analize, na izračune in meritve in nekako vedno bolj izključujemo ugibanje iz procesa projektiranja. Na to vplivajo po eni strani kvalitetne raziskave, in po drugi strani tudi sam proces projektiranja, ki se spreminja, kjer dejansko vedno več ljudi lahko, strokovnjakov na posameznih ozkih področjih sodeluje in s tem dosežemo skupaj dosti boljše rezultate.